Hello ladies and gentlemen, my name is Brian and today we're talking about the cheapest Razer gaming laptop available at the moment. It's currently on a huge discount and if you want to be the first to know about the best Amazon deals, I highly recommend you to follow our new Telegram channel Deals of the Day. Now let's get back to our video, we're gonna run through the specs real fast, I'm gonna let you know the in-game FPS that you can get with this laptop, and in the end we'll make a little conclusion after which you will decide if this laptop is the one you need. Traditionally, let's start with the screen, and although it's the base 2020 model, it still has a fantastic and above the competitor's panel. It's a 15.6-inch Full HD 120Hz fluid smooth screen with the maximum brightness level at 300 nits and 100% sRGB color gamut coverage. This is an insane advantage over all other laptops at this budget. It's great for photo and video editing, for gaming and watching movies or videos. Everything looks so crisp and seamless on it. Now the design of the machine stays kind of the same all the way from 2018. It's minimalistic, thin, stylish, and this is the laptop you'd want to pull out in public and show off a little. The keyboard is beautiful and it's comfortable, the touchpad is big and the bezels around the screen are really narrow. The laptop is made of aluminum and it's solid, but after a couple days of usage the fingerprints are all over it. The fact that it's black really helps, so the prints are visible only under specific angles. Now let's talk about the hardware, and it's pretty controversial thing about this machine. The CPU here is a 10th generation 14nm 6-core 12-threads Intel Core i7 with the base frequency at 2.6 GHz and a maximum is 4.8 GHz, which is really good for a laptop. Its power consumption is 45 watts and it's totally enough for any modern games, video editing, coding and so on. Now the graphics card. It's not the newest model as well, it's a 6GB VRAM NVIDIA GTX 1660 Ti with the power consumption at 80 watts. And this is the controversial part. For this exact amount of money you can get much more powerful laptops with newest generation RTX 3060 with 6GB memory on board, new ray tracing cores, Tensor cores and other new technology which is about 30% more powerful than 1660 Ti. For example, let's take MSI GF 65 Thin. I mean, yes, it doesn't look as cool as Razer laptops, it's not as comfortable and compact, the screen isn't that bright and colorful, but in terms of in-game performance and cooling, it's a way better solution. Plus, it has 512GB SSD on board against 256GB unit in our today's video's hero, but alright, I understand that you need some time to process this info, think about it, and we'll get back to it in the conclusions part. Now talking about RAM, we got 16GB DDR4 memory which is expandable. When I opened my laptop I saw that there are two sticks of 8GB memory each inside and this machine supports up to 32GB total of random access memory. So if you want to max this thing out you'll need two sticks of 16GB RAM each. I'll drop a link to the suitable sticks in the description box for you, feel free to check them out. And as I said before, it has 256GB M.2 NVMe SSD inside, which is really fast and expandable as well. There is another one empty slot for additional M.2 SSD units supporting up to 2TB storage, so yeah, there is definitely some room to grow. And here comes probably the most interesting part for most of you ladies and gentlemen, the in-game FPS, which I've tested personally on this device. All testings were done with the resolution set to 1920 by 1080 pixels and the in-game FPS settings set to high. Also, I want to admit that you can run any game at ultra settings and the frame rate in most cases won't drop down below 60, which is really cool. Now ladies and gentlemen, if this list is something you were looking for, I'd be so pleased if you hit the like button below this video, it will really help to grow the channel and also it's a serious motivation for me. Alright now, what I also like about this laptop is that it's absolutely travel friendly. My good friend has one of these for almost a year now and I know he's took his laptop to Germany, Great Britain and France and he's so obsessed with how comfortable this thing is during travels. It weighs only 2kg and the thickness is 20.5mm and taking into account its hardware and its metal case, this is insane. Now, of course it has a nice and crisp 720p HD webcam for game streaming and video conferences. The port selection is pretty well rounded including USB Type-C, a couple of Type-A's, HDMI and a combined MIDI jack for your mic and headphones. The user-facing speakers sound really good and loud. RGB keyboard has full-size keys but no number pad.
I have to make a little pause right here. The keyboard is awesome and I absolutely love it.
Alright now, making a conclusion, I want to say that this laptop is a good balanced device in terms of hardware, design, screen quality and build quality. The thing is that in my honest opinion, it's a bit overpriced. When it's at a discount, it's absolutely worth the money. It's great for studying, 3D modeling, coding, gaming, streaming, creative work like photo and video editing, traveling, and so on. This is really a compact and versatile device with an iconic design. But when it's not on sale, for full price, for 1500 bucks, I think there are better options. And ladies and gentlemen, that's it for the video. I really hope it was helpful for you, and now you know for sure if this laptop is the one you need. I highly recommend you to check out my new Telegram channel Deals of the Day, where I post the best Amazon discounts on tech-related products available at the moment.
Link is in the description.
Also, don't forget to check out those additional RAM sticks, and if you have any questions to me, let me know about them in the comments below, because I'm always here to help. Ladies and gentlemen, see you in the next video.